you.
Yeah.
Small startups to global corporations. Join me as we go inside the dynamic business world and explore some of today's successful companies. Welcome to Modern Business. When you think of home, you think of family, you think of community, the place where you work, where you live out your days with the ones you love. Here's one place people love to call home.
From its Wild West beginnings a century and a half ago to its current status as capital of Wyoming, the city of Cheyenne has come a long way. Welcome to the magic city of the plains, Cheyenne, Wyoming.
Cheyenne was founded in 1867. We are located in the northern end of the Front Range Urban Corridor. We benefit from being the capital city for the state of Wyoming, as well as being in close proximity to Colorado communities that have dense populations, diverse employment opportunities, and fantastic educational infrastructure.
Ideal for those pursuing a higher education, the city lies within 30 minutes of two major university campuses, the University of Wyoming and Colorado State. Cheyenne is situated at the intersection of several important transportation systems, two interstate highways, two major railroads, and it's a 90-minute drive to Denver International Airport with all of its connecting routes to the rest of the world.
Cheyenne continues to invest in itself, including investments in quality of life, basic infrastructure, and education. Quality of life investments include expansion to the Greenway project and to our parks. Education includes new schools and new facilities at the Laramie County Community College.
Being the state capital, it's not surprising that government agencies provide the bulk of the local employment. This is the proud home of F.E. Warren Air Force Base, which not only serves as a key employer, but also as a source for a well-trained, well-disciplined workforce. Other private sector employers include Microsoft, EchoStar, a satellite uplink center, and Sierra Trading Post, a popular retail and catalog outlet. This is also home to the National Centers for Atmospheric Research, whose resources include two supercomputers named Yellowstone and Cheyenne.
Cheyenne, Wyoming is a great place to relocate your business. We know that nationally, two of the top concerns of business in today's economic climate are labor and transportation. Cheyenne has great answers for you for both.
The Civic Center provides a full schedule of theatrical performances and serves as the home to the Cheyenne Symphony Orchestra. Depot Plaza is a popular gathering place with its restaurant and transportation museum. It's also a hot venue for concerts along with a regular farmer's market. Once a year, Cheyenne citizens kick up their heels, let down their hair, and celebrate the daddy of them all, Cheyenne Frontier Days. the nation's largest outdoor rodeo, complete with parades, art shows, Native American arts and culture, plus music.
I believe Cheyenne is well poised for continued growth. We have the best weather and geographic location for data centers, e-commerce, communication, as well as wind and solar energy. Add that to a place to go home, raise a family, and you have Cheyenne in a nutshell.
It's amazing what a bunch of rowdy settlers can do in 150 years.
Welcome to the State of the City Address for 2018. Thank you so much for coming. You just watched the nearly final video, which is why there was the time code stamp on there, put together by the producers of Modern Business. A few months into the job, last year, I was contacted by the producers of Modern Business with Kevin Harrington from Shark Tank as the host, and they wanted to feature various communities from around the country, and Cheyenne was on their radar. Thank you to Dale and Randy, who should have filmed the outtakes. This segment will air in 25 states and 25 targeted markets over the next few months. Additionally, we have access to a condensed version, minus the Shark Tank guy, for Leeds, the Chamber, Visit Cheyenne, or anyone else wanting to promote our community to use. Watching it makes me feel very proud of our community, and I hope you feel the same. But we didn't create it so we can feel good about ourselves. We created it so we could communicate to others about Cheyenne and what we have to offer. And communication is a big part of my theme today. One of the things that I campaigned on, because I felt so strongly about it, was communicating with the public. Not to, but with. We communicate with. A conversation has two sides. We needed to do a better job communicating with our citizens. That's why we started live streaming our city council meetings. That's why with council, we held town hall meetings and open houses. That's why we go out into the community and ask questions. We listen. The other morning, I rode along with Kenny Alvarado with the Cheyenne Sanitation Department. I met Kenny at 6 o'clock in the morning, and we picked up trash, navigating the streets and alleys and overturned containers. It was a windy morning. During this experience, I listened and I learned. On Christmas Eve, I went out with Randy Hickman in his snowplow. I can tell you, you wouldn't want me behind the wheel of a snowplow. Poor visibility, oncoming cars, parked cars. If only it was as easy as shoveling a sidewalk. I listened and I learned. A couple weeks ago, I went on a ride along with Cheyenne Police Officer Chad Wellman and his canine companion Ruger. Ruger's trained, among other things, in drug detection. I wasn't in the car 10 minutes, and the highway patrol was requesting the assistance of Ruger's talents. Knowing that at any minute the situation could go south, I will tell you that my heart was in my throat during that stop. I listened, and I learned. On Friday, I attended the Purple Heart ceremony with Tech Sergeant Doug Smits. I listened to his story of heroism and sacrifice. I had the honor of meeting Sergeant Smits and his fellow comrades at the Schwartz Memorial Plunge last year, an icy jump in the Sloan's Lake, to memorialize Tech Sergeant Matthew Schwartz, an ordnance disposal technician who was stationed at F.E. Warren and killed in the line of duty in 2012. Yep, I took the icy plunge last year, and I double dog dare any of you, especially council, to join me on January 27th again. But why these conversations? Why these experiences? We learn. We want to better understand. Our citizens need to know what their public servants are doing. And know to the word servant. And our public servants need to know what our citizens think. The purpose of the State of the City is to look back at 2017 and to look ahead to 2018. It starts with our community, recognizing our volunteer community, especially our 150th birthday celebration volunteers, that in a few months' time, together put a celebration that we will never forget. Thank you. Our former living mayors, each of them, Mayors Nation, Erickson, Pando, Schaefer, Spiker, and Kaysen, were present and shared a wealth of experience not not only with the community, but to me privately as a new member of their club. Thank you to our city council. This part-time job often fills full-time, I'm sure. I appreciate our candid conversations and a shared commitment to doing the right thing by our citizens. To our elected officials here today, county and state, thank you. We are all in this together. To our department head officials, the experience you bring collectively to the table, your team spirit, your solid counsel and advice to my office is truly invaluable. I believe we assembled the right team at the right time, and anything is possible. To our city employees, you are the backbone of this city. Without you, any ideas, any movement, any growth cannot occur. Thank you. To friends and family, and I believe I speak for all of us that work for the city, we couldn't do the work we do without your support. To my husband Jimmy, who's here today, I couldn't ask for a better partner and friend. Your patience with me is award-winning. To my children Katie and Jack, who are students at the University of Wyoming, thank you for your humor. Laughter is always the best medicine. We are in exciting and challenging times. The economic picture has not been friendly. Predictions of doom and gloom abounded. I remember that when I took office. Lean times were ahead, yet we persevered, and we have a lot to be proud of in 2017. Our city, the magic city on the plains, turned 150, and the amount of civic pride that our community showed was spectacular. Cheyenne came together, and I'm so proud of our community. We had growth when none was predicted. We had a surplus when serious deficits were predicted. Cheyenne has weathered the state's economic storm better than most. We have the opportunity to lead the state. I remember the boom and the bust of the 70s and 80s, and if we all had a nickel for every time we heard the phrase, "We must diversify our economy," well, we'd be pretty well off. I believe if we want to change, if we want to diversify, then we need to quit begging our state leaders to do something. They've been talking about diversification for decades. It's not going to start with the state. History has proven so. I believe the only way it can happen is to start with our cities and our towns. We must take individual community responsibility. Cheyenne is not Casper. Cheyenne is not Rock Springs. Cheyenne is not Sheridan. So while the state of the state is important, it's the state of our cities and our towns that is the critical foundation. Once again, government, the state, must get out of the way of our communities. We need to stop looking to our state leaders to solve our economic woes and instead look in the mirror. It begins locally. That's where the opportunity is. That is where we find the greatest change can happen in the most nimble and the most responsive way. Let's take a moment to look back at 2017. At City Hall, we began the year off by implementing the recommendations of staff and employees and transformed the way city government operates through a substantial reorganization. We did this to create efficiencies, tear down silos, and build up communication, increase transparency, decrease spending, and we did so without laying people off. An amazing group of volunteers gathered to bring our community together to celebrate our 150th birthday. Thank you to our very generous community, from fireworks to birthday cake, the concerts and time capsule. We did not spend taxpayer money having a really special celebration. Together with City Council, our staff produced a budget that cuts spending and recognizes savings. And unlike almost every other community in the state, we ended our fiscal year over $1.5 million in the black without having to dip into reserves. As you recall, I campaigned on fixing the roads. And that's one thing I can guarantee you that will never make anyone happy. I get that. But there are ways to do things better. You gotta listen. Our outgoing city engineer, Jim Buller, kept telling me the better way. Instead of expensive grinding overlay, let's chip seal the roads. Otherwise, we'll get further and further behind. Why do it this way? Let's look at the economic realities. We don't have the budget to replace our streets. We don't, and we won't have it. So, Do we continue to piecemeal our roads and only take care of the worst of the worst? Or do we go another route and actually make real progress? With chip sealing, we extend the life of what we have. It's an excellent return on our dollars. We chip sealed nearly 10 miles of roads, developed a new pavement management program, and our engineering department was able to save hundreds of thousands of dollars in managing stormwater drainage and environmental cleanup projects. Our goal is to have 100 miles of road work done by the end of this four-year administration. When I ran for office, one of my priorities was to put more police on the street. We have. 10 new officers were sworn in 2017. Other mayors do what I do. They steal the best people. And Chief Kozak is a wanted man. Numerous cities have reached out to him to lead their police departments, and we've been able to retain him. And we should all feel very fortunate that he's here. Thank you to Chief Kozak for the work you do. We did a national search for a new fire chief. Why? Because Cheyenne deserves to have the very best. A proven leader will grow a future department. And our young department is very, very fortunate to have Chief Hoggett with the wealth of experience and leadership that I know will grow our future leaders. We are embracing technology and transparency. We Facebook Live our city council meetings, and even this gathering today. We tweet, we Instagram, we Facebook, all in the name of getting information out to the public in real time. And if you don't follow our police department on Facebook, you should. We even communicate with humor. Here's an example.
All right, guys, today we're going to start our 2018 goals for the department, which includes increasing our high visibility speed enforcement. Officer Long, I got you partnered up with R2 today. You guys go out there, and that'll be your focus for the entire shift, is just conducting speed enforcement. Anybody else that wants to join in, feel free to join in as well.
You got it, Sarge.
Hey, R2, let's do our part for the 2018 department goals. I know a spot where there are a lot of speeders. I'll let you out up here to run some radar. We'll see what we can get.
All right, R2, let's see if we can catch this guy. What did you clock him at? That sounds about right, 10 over.
Sub-6 will be at 15th and Bent with two counting Nader. That's two counting Victor, Adam, David, Edward, Robert.
Hello, everybody.
What is my opinion? I am you now.
And I stopped you for going 10 over. I also saw you trying to use the force on my door over there. So what I'm going to have to do is I'm going to have to give you a citation for unlawful use of the force, but I'm going to give you a warning on the speed.
I find your lack of faith disturbing.
That only works on troopers. All right. You can play. You can actually pay that online now. All right, so have a good day, and may the police force be with you.
pretty great, don't you think? Taxpayers voted for a new municipal court building, a critical community connector in Christensen Overpass, funding for an east side park, greenway expansion, redeveloped the west edge, moving forward with the Civic Center Commons Park, Reed Avenue Rail Corridor, and Pump House Park. It's been an exciting year for what was Parks and Recreation and is now Community Recreation and Events. Again, thanks to this community, we now have a beautiful all-ability playground in Cahill Park. We are updating the play equipment at Holiday Park and restoring Big Boy to its glory. We continue to work on greenway improvements in parks and the way in which we book events and activities. Thanks to David Sewell, who we stole away from the Griffin Theater in Laramie, we have booked an event here at the Civic Center nearly every week since he came to work for us during summer. We are filling this hall with a wide variety of entertainment. I can personally tell you this place was packed the week before Christmas for a pajama party screening of Polar Express, and a Harry Potter viewing experience is slated for next month. These are family-friendly, extremely affordable events to complement our symphony and the off-Broadway acts. This is our community center, and we are treating it as such. And we certainly can't leave out the Grand Conservatory of Botanic Gardens to open this year, yet another community investment that is a crown jewel. I challenge anyone who says Cheyenne doesn't have great amenities. Cheyenne has incredible entertainment, arts, outdoor recreational amenities, and I believe it's only going to get better. We are fighting the blight by saying no more to abandoned and dangerous buildings. We've identified the worst offenders and are taking measurable action with demolition of 815 Capitol Avenue scheduled for the first quarter of this year. These properties didn't deteriorate overnight, and addressing blight will and should continue to be an important sense of who we are, community pride in every one of our neighborhoods. We will not stop. We will clean up Cheyenne. The first thing I mentioned when I announced my candidacy for office was the Hitching Post. This once grand meeting place has been a disaster for more than a decade. For the first time now, in more than a decade, we have progress. This disaster has been shut down. Now we're discussing how to tear it down, remove it, get rid of it, and make the area poised for renewal. 2018 will be the year for redevelopment. There is promising development of the Cole Shopping Center, potential at the Z's building, and yes, I believe the literal hole in the heart of our downtown, the Heinz building, will see progress. Part of the problem with development is our regulatory climate. We've made it so difficult for entrepreneurs, people who want to make real improvements. And as I've said, we need to get out of our own way. And we listened. We heard about this guy from Sheridan, Robert Briggs, who completely changed the regulatory climate in Sheridan. He turned it upside down, turned it pro-growth, pro-private investment, pro-how can we help you. So what did we do? We stole him. We hired him. Sheridan was not happy, but we needed that type of an entrepreneurial spirit here in Cheyenne, and Robert is now creating a one-stop approach here in Cheyenne. We have a planning and development department that is progressive and taking action to make Cheyenne a place where developers and builders are met with, how can we help? We needed a bridge builder, figuratively, in engineering. We needed someone with that type of entrepreneurial spirit that Robert Briggs brings, so we listened. We heard about this woman, Amy Allen from Rock Springs, who's an engineer and has navigated that community through EPA and DEQ hoops, oversaw the Public Works Department, and as well as planning and development. This means that she knows how to work with all of the players. So what did we do? We stole her. We hired her. Rock Springs was not happy, but we needed that type of entrepreneurial spirit here in Cheyenne. Like every community, Cheyenne isn't without its share of challenges. Among them include recruiting and retaining our workforce, affordable housing, including that for our servicemen and women at FE Warren Air Force Base, downtown development, speeding, it's one of the greatest complaints I get, community and business development, and last but not least, broadband connectivity. And herein lie the opportunities to collectively meet these head on. Thanks to the efforts spearheaded by Dale Steenbergen at the Chamber, Randy Bruin with Leeds, and Dr. Joe Schaefer at LCCC, we are embarking on creating a data-driven roadmap for planning the future of Cheyenne to determine both the economy and the workforce needed for our future. There will be more to come in the weeks and months ahead, and I'm committed to these efforts as well. A true partnership between F.E. Warren, the city, the county, the Board of Public Utilities has emerged in addressing the housing needs of our servicemen and women. Pair that with food, entertainment, and shopping experiences, and we will together have created an exciting new community for both our base and our civilian community. And credit to Dale Steenbergen for forging those relationships and putting this exciting new development within an attainable reach. Simply put, we're talking about developing the vacant land off of I-25 that we all commonly know as the Cheyenne Frontier Days Park and Ride area, over 70 acres of housing and commercial development. Think Centerra. This will be the likes of development that Cheyenne has not seen. Perhaps it's the altitude, or we can blame the wind, that pushes so many of our motorists to treat our roadways like raceways. I've had enough. I know you have. And I implore the Wyoming State Legislature to vote against reducing the fine schedule for speeders. This is a very serious public safety matter, and we must not go soft, but rather just the opposite. I do not accept that there's nothing more that we can do to stop speeding in our community. I won't accept it. I charged our police department to make this a priority, and they've answered the call, as you saw. If it involves cranking the fines, so be it. Maybe people won't risk it. We can't go soft. I'm excited to announce two more initiatives in 2018, in addition to the ongoing efforts to fight the blight, improving roads, and infrastructure. The first is a formalized business ombudsman program in planning and development. This is not an additional full-time position, but rather taking existing jobs and resources to dedicate a single point of contact, one city staff member, to a potential new or existing business to walk them through from start to finish. If other communities can do it, you bet we can too. The second, I will be naming a broadband task force in the coming days, and I've asked Eric Trowbridge, headmaster and executive director of the Array School of Technology and Design, better known as ET2S, to chair this task force, and he accepted the challenge. If we are going to truly be competitive, we must treat access to high speed, and I'm talking 1 gig up and down, as accessible as turning on the tap and having water, flipping a switch and having light, and it must be affordable. Cheyenne is failing on both accounts, accessibility and affordability. We will have progress. And I'm telling Eric Trowbridge to lead the hell out of this task force, Eric. Do what you do. Again, this means government getting out of the way with our archaic fee schedules, instead creating policy that encourages, if not demands, a one dig or one trench approach. Fort Collins voters just recently passed a municipally run broadband initiative. I want all options on the table. This is going to be a fast-paced and high-energy community with the first set of recommendations due in 60 days to mirror and work closely with the governor's endow and the Wyoming Business Council to address this very critical infrastructure. 150 years ago, our magic city of the Plains grew overnight, and I believe 2018, launching into our next 150 years, we will see that kind of spark again. We were a city of entrepreneurial spirit. Let's rekindle this. Let's have every means possible to ignite the kind of community we want to grow. There are inspirational examples all around us with this kind of spirit. New businesses are opening where others have closed their doors. We are planning for generations into the future with the annexation of the Sweetgrass development, over 2,000 acres in South Cheyenne. We are growing East Cheyenne. We can't be naive that the Front Range is growing, and it will happen whether we're at the table or not. Which is why I asked for a meeting with the mayors of the communities along the Front Range, Windsor, Wellington, Greeley, Loveland, and Fort Collins. We met last month, and we pledged to continue our discussions, recognizing we share a workforce and workforce needs. We share transportation issues and transportation needs in air, rail, and highway. We can't ignore the fact that economic development knows no state lines, no city, or no district boundaries. Cheyenne now has a seat at the table. What I learned most in the past year, and what I implore the collective us to do in this new year, is to listen, and not just verbal. Listen to what's being said on social media. Listen to those whose past experience is just as valuable to us as what is trending now. Because now, more than ever, we must be active listeners. Cheyenne, our future is just as outstanding and remarkable as was our beginning. We grew from a population of 600 to 4,000 in a year. Now, I'm not suggesting that kind of population growth. However, what you may not know, that by the time electric lights were installed in 1882, Cheyenne was the wealthiest city per capita in the world. Think about that. Our forefathers were self-starters, the entrepreneurs of their time. Cheyenne, entrepreneurial success, grit, and candid attitude is in our blood. Some may say we have challenges ahead, and to that I say, the opportunities are boundless. Thank you to everyone here today, and to our community for making 2017 a year to remember. 2018, look out, here we come. Cheers to a new year, God bless, and Godspeed. Thank you so much.